So now you've seen that you can encode four things in bits. You can encode any number, though. We just need more bits. So if we have more bits, we can encode more different things. So here I've got four bits. That means I have four yes-no choices, and I can encode 16 different numbers. And the reason for that is because 2 to the 4 is 16. Every time I add one more bit, I double the number of things because I have one more yes-no question. So for just this part of the graph, I had 8 things. I had 3 bits. I could distinguish between the numbers 0 through 7. Adding one more bit doubles the number of things I can distinguish. So that's a way to measure information. And once we can distinguish any number of things, well, we can send any kind of data we want. Anything that's discrete, we can turn into a number. So we could turn letters into numbers. If we have a long string, we could have a sequence of numbers, which we can turn into one really big number. So once we can send bits, we can send anything we want. So that's what bandwidth is. It's a measure of the amount of information that we can send, and we're measuring the number of bits. Each bit is one yes or no decision. In computing, we usually think of that as either a 0 or a 1. So that long stream of zeros and ones is the information we're sending, and it could be encoding a string of text like it does in a web page. It could be encoding an image. It could be encoding a number. And to measure our bandwidth, we need to know how many bits can we send per second.